my name's Devon, and welcome to Barbell Strength number 20. What can you expect over the next hour? Well, we're going to do a 5 to 6 minute warm-up. We're going to rehearse many of the movements that are going to come up later on. So if you get a little bit lost and overwhelmed with the terminology and the quick change of movement, don't get frustrated. I promise you it gets easier for the rest of the workout, and by the time you've done this video a couple of times, you'll get it no problem. We then move on to 8 muscle groups. We're going to start with the larger muscle groups. That's going to be the legs, the chest, and the back. We'll be in each of these muscle groups for about 5 to 6 minutes, executing at least 100 reps per muscle group. We then go on to the smaller muscle groups. That's going to be the triceps, the biceps, the shoulders, and the abs. But we're going to hit the legs just one more time. Now, I'm going to be playing with the range of movement and the tempo to take you to fatigue within that last minute of each song. So if you've got the right weight, in that last minute, you should be wanting to put down the weights. All right, guys, so like I said, if you're looking to shred, refine, define, turn your body into a fat burning machine, this is the class for you. Now, what do you need in way of equipment? Well, obviously it's barbell strength, so I've got a barbell and a selection of plates. If you don't have a barbell, if you have some dumbbells, anywhere from 3 to 20 pounds would be absolutely ideal. I will be using a bench, but that's just to lie on when we do the chest work. That can be done from the floor, so if you don't have a bench, not a problem at all. I also have a mat at the back for the abdominal section at the end. So if you guys are ready to go, let's get warmed up. All right, guys, before we get going, let's get our set position. Reach down, pick up your bar. You're taking it to an overhand grip. Your hand placement, thumb distance from the outside of the thighs. You want to roll the shoulders up, back, and down. Knees soft, heels grounded. Pull the shoulder blades together and maintain that length of the spine the whole way through. Are you guys ready to go? Take it gently. 2, 3, and up. Down, 1, up, 3. Keep that bar close to the body. Legs almost straight. Just a little bend in the knees to activate the hamstrings. Dead row. Knees bend, knees and thighs. We're going to drive the elbows to the back of the room. That bar touches the ribcage every time. Triple row. Pull the elbows back 3 times. Here's 1. Here's 2. Guys, we're going to take it up, roll the shoulders with weight. 4 clean presses, take it in, up, in, and down. Now look how close I'm keeping that bar to my body. Rotating the wrist at shoulder height. Triple overhead, take it up. Press for 3, here's 1. Here's 2, lower it down, do that again. Guys, we're going into an upright row. Up, 3, down, 1. You're easy in the elbows, to shoulder height only. Up, 1, down, 3. Raising the bodies. We're going to hit the posterior chain again. Back to dead lift. Down 2, up 2. Dead row. Knees and belly. Knees and thighs. Dead lift. Just a dead row. Knees and belly. Little hesitation at the top. Activate posterior delts. Triple row. Pull back for 3. Rise up. Do it again. And guys, we're going to hesitate with a shoulder roll. Rise up. Shoulder roll. Please don't press. So I'm using my legs to I'll try that way overhead. I sit, I try, I sit, I drop. Triple overhead. Three, two, lower the bar. Do it again. Now this time we're going to keep the bar up. Hold it up. Place up the meaty part of the upper back. Prepare for squats. Here we go, guys. Slow. It's all you and my mind. Now think about sit back into a chair. I'm careful, I stay beside you. Down three, up one. Negative breath. At the base of the movement, you want to be able to wiggle the toes. You got it. Down one, up three. Control the ascent. Try not to rush. We're going to add a little bit of pressure, guys. Take it down. Lower range. Breathing 1 inch over the knees. Rise up. Alright, we're going to hit the last pedal. So no range of movement. Single squats right here down. You want to squeeze the butt at the top. Power thrust through the heels. Drive. Now guys, little bit deeper, take it down. You got it. Feel our heart rate climb. Guys, we're going to put the brakes back on. Super slow weight. We're preparing for slow lunges. Left leg, take it back. Lunge. Back. Drop. And right leg. Drive through that front heel to come up. Hands knee down towards the floor. Now hold it in. Slowly lower the bar for four. Slowly lower to the front of the shoulder. Control it. Rotate the wrist, lower down to the waist for four. Left hand under. Right hand under. Bicep curl, sits up and down. Lower that core. Stabilize the upper body. Now, halfway up and down. All the way up and down. Half. Raise it up. One more. Take it halfway up and hold. Boom. Nice work, guys. Carefully lower the bar. All right. We are moving on to legs one. This is your squat track. Now this is your heaviest weight of the day, guys. Now, unlike at Barbell Strength 19, where we had searches and front squats and thrusters, this time we're keeping the bar on your back the entire time with a traditional back squat. That means you can go a little heavier. We're in for about just over 6 minutes. Now what we're doing today is we're working on different types of stances. We're gonna start with a mid-range stance, so the feet are just over hip distance apart. Then, we're going back to the sumo. Now, we worked on that quite extensively in Barbell Strength number 19. So it's all about turning the toes out, and at the base of the movement, feeling that ignition in the inner thighs. Now, this time, we have a narrow squat. This is challenging, guys. You're gonna bring the feet in closer together under the hips, okay? As you sit back, you're going to find that it limits your range of movement and it's going to feel like it bites a little bit deeper into the quadricep. If that's too hard for you, obviously go back to a mid-stance. So, if you're new, I'm going to say, I don't know, maybe 12 and a half to 15 pounds on each side. Advanced people, if you want to take it up to 20 or even 25 pounds each side, go for it. I always advise the first time doing this routine, just go a little bit lighter. Alright guys, we just only hit distance apart. Ready? Down two, up two. Here we go, push it down. Track the glutes at the top. Elbows under, hands lift up. I'll set. Left heel up. Right heel. Left heel. Right heel. We pull back to offset four. Lift it up, guys. Down. Three, up, one. Wait.
You got to keep on bouncing.
You're not going to be ready back move.
So when the baseline hits you, you know just what to do. Sounds like you're jumping in a pogo. Sounds like you're jumping in a pogo. Sounds like you're jumping in a pogo.
Now, no break. Stay down.
You got to keep on bouncing. You're not going to take my move. So when the baseline hits you, you know just what to do. Sounds like you're jumping in a pogo.
Hold on. Great. So we got to jump pedal.
Bounce to the beat like a
jump. Keep going, hit it. A little bit lower. Every single repetition counts. Wake up, wake up. Come on. Offset squat. Let's feel up and keep it up. Keep that left heel up, guys. Keep driving through. Four into movement. You got it. Let's go down. Right heel up. A little bit deeper. Come on, we're feeling it today. Pick it up, hold it up and wait. Take it to sumo, guys. Close down. Here we go. Take it slow. Slower. Down two, up two. Go. No beginning, no end. Don't block out the joints, guys. Keep that tension. Building. Down three, up one. Here we go. Take it three, two, one. How low can you go? Kneel. Now fight the inner thighs. Don't block out at the top. Keep tension in that working muscle. Guys. Down and hold. Rock. Get ready, slow, four. It's gonna limit your range of movement, guys. Sit back into that invisible chair. Weight is in the heels. Can you wiggle your toes at the bottom of movement? Down two, up two. Like before, no beginning, no end. Keep that tension on your working muscle. Feel that body, every single rep. Test it, test the water, set to beat a beeper. Every single time, down and hold. Down, two, three, four. All right, guys, you know it's coming. Let's go build. Nice job, guys. Whew, safely. Clean and press that bar overhead and place it down on the floor. Nice work. Have yourself a drink. Let's talk about your chest track. All right, how do you design the chest track? We've always been starting off with a bar recently, right? This time we're gonna start off with chest flies, okay? So you're gonna be having some dumbbells. You're gonna be lying on the bench or the floor. You're gonna hold those dumbbells directly above the shoulders, and you're gonna be taking them down, full range of movement. You notice there's a little crook in my elbow. The straighter the arm, the harder it is, okay? Now when you're taking that full range of movement, once you get to a certain point, which is usually a little bit lower than the bench, you're also gonna feel the biceps and the shoulders jump in to assist. All right, guys? Now, we're gonna be working in that half range again. Down and halfway up, down and halfway up. We did that in barbell strength number 19, where we came down for three, overloaded, and came all the way up for four. Today, we're down for seven. We have also got an isometric hold for about eight counts. So I'm gonna recommend you go a little bit lighter on those dumbbells than you did in the last routine. Usually for the girls, around 8 to 12. Guys, maybe you can take it up to about 15 pounds. Hey, if I've underestimated your strength, go for it, you know you. Then, once we have fried the muscle with those flies, you're gonna have the barbell at the end of the bench, and we are going straight into our chest presses. Wide grip chest press, guys. It will be up to tempo, not a slow pace like the last routine. So go ahead, get the dumbbells that you're gonna need. I recommend you keep your squat weight on your bar, or even heavier. All right, guys, if you're on a bench, a three-point connection, what do I mean by that? Knees bent, feet flat on the floor. Lower back is in connection with the bench, as is the shoulders, okay? Try not to let the lower back arch on the floor, so staple the navel into the bench in preparation for your flies. Starting with weights just above the shoulders, ready, guys? Down three, up one, down two, three, drive on up, down, full range of movement, squeeze into the chest, to let those dumbbells overhead, reversing down, one, up, three, two, three. Now guys, brace on, slow it down for four, three, now low range, halfway up and down for three, two, all the way up on four, two, three again, take it halfway up and down, all the way up, two again, that's seven, six, all that's getting hard, that's maximum tension on the muscle, it's three, it's two, all the way up, now super slow it down, the four, from the top, up three, down one, up two, three, that's your concentric contraction, muscles shortening as it gains tension, three, reverse it, up one, down two, there's your eccentric. Now, super slow. Up for four, three, take it halfway down. Hold it at center, three. Woo! All the way up. Oh my goodness. Just do it at that 1 inch. Do that tension in the muscle. Do it for seven, six. I know, I did it too.
Three, two, shape, right? This time, 8 singles. Here we go, it's 8. Good job, guys. Come on up. Underhand grip to take that bar off of your lap. How did you get on with those? All right, we are about to go onto your back track. All right, now your back track is a big, powerful track today, okay? Going to be using the bar. If you want to substitute with dumbbells, that is fine. If you're new or don't feel too strong today, maybe 7.5 to 10 pound plates on each side. Advanced people, you know where to go. However, I will tell you that my stronger athletes that usually are up around 17.5 to 20 pound plates each side have not been able to make it through that weight and they have had to come down. All right, so keep that in mind. Go with a lighter weight the first time you do this routine and see how you get on. There's no hand clean, so everything is going to be your deadlifts and your dead rows. Now, we will see the return of 8 clean and presses in a row. Now, watch this, a clean and press. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a 4-count move. If you get winded or you have a shoulder impingement and you can't do a clean and press, you will modify with a dead row. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's also a 4-count move. So whether you're doing the clean and press or the dead row, we will stay together. Now, in the second track, we're going to do 4 clean and presses in a row. Then we've got a doozy. We are going to try 7 push presses. Now, if that's too much for you, just do another 4 clean and presses. So remember that, guys. 4 clean and presses, 7 push presses. If you don't want to do the 7 push presses, do 8 clean and presses in a row, and we will finish together. By the same token, you can do 8 dead rows, and we will still finish together. Are you guys ready? First of all, let's get your set position. Feet hip width apart, overhand grip. Thumb width from the outside of the thighs. Roll the shoulders up, back and down. Now feel the length and strength in your spine. I want you to maintain that, okay? No slouching and no collapsing through the back. Are you guys ready? Thank you.
place, guys. Are you ready? Deadlift. Tricep kickback in barbell strength 19, and it's going to see a return here. So you remember how much you focused on keeping the hand on the thigh. When your back is in this position, we call that unsupported forward flexion, and your back is vulnerable to injury. So you need to engage the core. What do I mean by that? Imagine someone's going to punch you in the belly, and you would contract your abs to deflect that punch, right? That's what we mean. Or think about putting your navel to your spine, if that helps you. The hand is on the thigh, and that supports the back. We don't want to be swinging. You often see people at the gym doing this, using momentum. It's unsafe, and it's ineffective. We want to be contracting and activating this three-headed muscle on the back of the upper arm. So we're going to start with the weight under the shoulder. We start at the shoulder. We extend, bring that wrist up in line with the elbow. We bring it back under the shoulder and lower it down. All right, guys? So that eliminates the momentum. Now we're going to do a straight arm kickback, and this is harder than you may realize. You might want to practice it with me and then decide what you want to do with your weight. So you're just going to take it all the way back as straight and high as you can. You're going to hold it for three counts and then lower it down. So the combination in, kick back, lower, straight arm back, hold, 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 and down. All right, guys? So that's pretty much all we're going to be doing at the end. We're just going to throw just a few overhead extensions. Nothing as bad as the last routine. All right, pick up your weapon and let's get going. I want love.
on to it. We're going to do a kick back and then that straight arm like this. Kick back, straight arm back. 3, 2, 1, and down. Kick back. Straight arm. Hold it as high as you can. It's kick back. Straight arm. Circle on in. Let's feel it. Easier for this one in Barbell Strength 20. Now how I've created it, we don't have the time under tension like we did in the last routine. However, what I've designed is to take it into maximum muscle chaos and confusion in order to take those muscles to fatigue very, very quickly. I'm talking under 3 minutes, okay? So I'm gonna first of all fatigue your muscles with the first song, and then we're gonna overload with the second one, okay? So if you're new, I'm going to say about 5 to 7.5 pound plates on each side. Advanced people, maybe come with me. Anywhere from about 10 to 15 pounds. You'll probably be struggling beyond that weight. But again, that's up to you. You know you and how strong you are. So let's explain what we're going to do. So we're going to start with our barbell in a neutral grip, okay? Typically with these bars, your hand is somewhere between the smooth and the grooved area. But just about here, elbows are by the waist without digging into the waist. The first one is a drag curl. A drag curl, guys, what you're gonna do is pull the elbows as far back behind your body as you can. So literally my rib cage is getting in the way of the bar, stopping me going back any further. So as you come up, you squeeze, 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 and it's gonna take that really deep into the head of the bicep. The next one, instead of taking the bicep curl just up to the shoulder, we're gonna bring it all the way up to the forehead, all right? So it's a bigger range of movement, and we're also gonna have to move a little bit quicker to keep up with the music. Now the last one, we're taking it to the maximum point of tension on the bicep, which is that 90 degree angle, halfway up and down, 2, 3, and then we overload it with a full range of motion on the fourth, okay? So we put those three together, they're pretty tough exercises as standalones, and we take you to muscle confusion. Okay guys, the second song, we're gonna take it out to that wide hand grip in the outer head of the bicep, and we'll just do a series of curls. Are you guys ready for this? I'm not sure I am, but I'm gonna hang on as long as I can. take it back to down.
We gotta think of a place we can go.
Up. All the way back, guys. Think about squeeze.
Anytime. If you wanna get out, then just let me know.
Squeeze, squeeze.
Hold my hand.
Forehead.
Let me take you down. Down. It's about to go down. Getting high.
All the way up to the forehead. You got it.
You won't have to feel lonely when you're alone. Movement, boom, then we have to put the brakes on, and then we have to overcome that inertia
to begin the full range of movement again. So it's that start, stop, again, the muscle chaos. So that was my theory in writing the bicep track like that. We're about to move on to legs two, which is your lunges. Now guys, I want you to go really, really heavy, or at least as heavy as you can handle, okay? So I'm gonna say if you have like 12 to 20 pounds, that would be ideal, if you can hold the weight, I know, after those biceps. It's a very, very simple lunge track today. We're gonna start with the curtsy lunges. Now, when we do the curtsy, I want you to square off your chest, shoulders, and hips. So think of your body on railroad tracks. And that way, as you take the leg behind, we're taking full advantage of that transverse lunge, okay? So it's your curtsy. You want to try and bring that knee as low as you can, and then drive on up. Then we're gonna take it to a rear lunge. When we do the rear lunge, the feet are at least hip width apart. If you feel you're on a tightrope, it means your feet are probably too narrow in their stance, so take it a little bit wider. As you come down, the chest stays up. You wanna bring that knee under the hip, bringing that knee down to the floor. Then you drive up into that front heel to step back again. We then add the combination. Curtsy, up, rear lunge, up. All right, then we're gonna add on a side lunge. We're gonna start with a negative rep. So with the side lunge, guys, I want you to take the leg out as far as you can. The toe is forward. You're gonna come down for a count of seven. That's your negative rep. 7, 6, 5, 4. Now, what's really important is you're not leaning over the side of your leg, okay? What you're actually doing is taking your butt to the back wall. So do it with me as you come down for seven. Bend, hinge at the hip, keep taking that butt to the back wall, further back, further back, further back. You see how low you get? Without having to lean over the leg and compromise your cruciate ligaments. Are you guys ready to go? Pick up your weapon. So we step, drop, up, step in.
Every time you come around,
square up your shoulders and hips. Ideally, if you're doing this, maybe you can see yourself in the mirror.
Every time the circle's down, I let you take control.
Take it to a real lunge, step it back. Step,
I can feel the
drop.
Conversations with a stranger up and low.
job, guys. How'd you do? If you were honest with yourself, could you have gone heavier? All right, so evaluate how you feel, and you make that decision next time. All right, we've made it to the shoulder track. It means you've only got one more muscle group after this, that's the abs. So we've done about 600 reps, guys, about 200 to go. So I'm gonna recommend you go to a lighter weight. Let me show you what's coming up and you can decide. I'm gonna recommend it anywhere from 3 to 12 pounds, depending on how strong your shoulders are and how you feel today. All right, so we're gonna be starting off with lateral raises, okay? Elbow just comes to shoulder height only. The straighter the arm, the harder it is. So if you're struggling, bend a little bit more at the elbow. You've also got a front raise. Again, shoulder height only. This time the palms are gonna be down. All right, guys, we also have that angel. We're gonna be going slow time. You're gonna feel lots of muscles come into play. Your shoulders, your biceps, your triceps, your lats, and of course the abs are working to support and stabilize. Then we're gonna hinge in the hip, and we're gonna take it into our good old reverse fly, no swinging, okay? Again, like a bird, the little crook in the wing, you'll fly. Now the T-raise, I believe we did this 3 or 4 routines ago. The T-raise, what you do is you take the palms to the back and you have a straight arm making the letter T. That's super challenging, guys. Then we're gonna finish off with the Cuban with a peg deck. So if you get a little bit lost, don't worry, I promise you, by the time you've done this a few times, you'll nail it. It is a lateral raise with a rotation up. Overhead press, peg deck, then you lower and draw it in. So I'll say out, up, up, down, in, out, and down, in. All right, that's all it's gonna be. So pick up your weapons, guys, your second dramatic piece of music, because it wouldn't be one of my workouts if we didn't have the drama, right? did you do? You think you can go heavier next time? Remember, you want to show up the muscles. You want to be a little bit intimidated by the weight that you selected. And that last minute, you should be really struggling. That was only about a 4.5 minute song, guys. All right, so if you can go heavier next time, go for it. So we've made it to the final track, the abdominals. Now I'm going to tell you, I have a pretty strong group of students. And this first week of this routine, all of them have been struggling to make it through with a dumbbell. So let's see how you get on. Let me explain to you what's going to come up, okay? So, dumbbell of your choice or none at all, maybe see how you feel. What we're going to do is we're going to come all the way up, then we're only going to come halfway back, so you're going to feel maximum tension in the abs, it will burn and shake. Then you're going to come all the way up before coming all the way down, alright? So it's up, halfway back, up, and all the way back. And we're going to be moving at a pretty good clip, which is going to fire up your fast twitch muscle fibers. Then we have a chop. A chop is straight up, and then you're going to try and take that dumbbell as far behind the hip as you can. Do you see my arms are pretty straight, okay? So it's kind of like a straight arm brush and twist in a way, all right? That's your chop right there. Then, guys, to make it really, really hard, we're going to hold halfway up. So again, you've got maximum tension on the abs. We're starting to starve the muscle of oxygen. In addition, we're going to try and march the legs. But I want you to imagine a little baby's bird egg right underneath the heel. So as you lower the heel, you don't want to break that egg. All right, guys? So this is it. Let's see how long you can hold on with this. And let's go. All right, let's practice it super slow together. All right, guys, pick up your weapon. We're going to come up really, really slow for four. We're just going to come halfway back. Feel that maximum tension in the abs. You're going to come all the way up, and then you're going to come all the way down. Let's do that again. So you're going to come all the way up. You're going to come halfway back. You're going to come all the way up, and all the way down. And hold.
You're coming in love again.
bird eggs and look at the heels. And put that dumbbell down. Oh my goodness, guys, 800 reps. You did it. Let's just take feet in one direction, hands overhead.
Questions that keep me awake. Would anyone